So I'm out here with my mom, and we're giving honor to Richard Rooley, pre-Memorial Day coming right up, and his wife and his son, Patricia's wife and his son Ross. And of course, Richard was in the United States Marine Corps during World War II and fighting the Japanese so that we could stay free as a nation. Just zoom in on that real quick. It's a beautiful arrangement. The mom picked this arrangement out. So it's a beautiful arrangement there. And then just a really nice placid area here, a peaceful area to kind of conduct a really nice small ceremony. You can see my Bible there. And we're also going to have a memorial for my Bible. That Bible was the Bible that I got. I asked Jesus Christ to be my Savior, and I had that Bible through Bible school. I preached out of that Bible a lot, and it's fallen apart. And my mom said the best way to have something like that, that's a prized possession, is to have it buried. So we're going to have a burial out here, and that's what we're going to do. So, but just wanted to share that with you. This is, again, the Bible that I used for many, many years. And it's just, it's falling apart. So it's time to have a ceremony for that. And my mom said that's the best way to give honor to something, whether it's the flag or a Bible or something, is to either bury it ceremonially or to have a burning. And of course, a burning of a flag is never done in front of a crowd where you're trying to show destruction to America. You're burning a flag in a ceremonial fashion, not to show respect and honor, which is what the Marine Corps is all about, isn't it, Mom?
Yes.
You want to say something? Just talk real loud.
The Marine Corps is extremely patriotic. Once you're a Marine, you're always a Marine. It's the world's largest fraternity, I used to say. Marines know each other, or meet each other, and they're old buddies right away.
Yeah. That branch of the service is definitely known for it really just honor.
Honor, and like I said, they are super patriotic. As Richard said, they never took the oath back that he took when he joined the Marines, so he was still under oath for the rest of his life.
I did not know that. Under oath for the rest of your life?
Yes.
Yeah, and when I asked Jesus Christ to be my Savior, I was under oath. Yeah, there's been plenty of times where I have not always, you know, been my best as a believer, been my best as a but one thing I can tell you is I've never dipped my colors in standing up for Jesus Christ. And I know Mom has never dipped his colors. Richard never dipped his colors. And I think that's the important thing, is it's God, family, and country. Wouldn't you say that, Mom?
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah, because if we lose our God or allow people to take away the freedom, like what's going on right now in our nation, where there's people that want to take away the freedom of God, and then they want, of course, after they take that away, which they're doing it through our school systems right now, and then if they take that away, then that's the prelude to what happened during Adolf Hitler, during Stalin. They re-educate all the children to believe one way, one thought, one mindset. Would you believe that?
Yes, that's true. That's what they did. And it was not a good thing.
Yeah, it's horrible. Because then people died, the people that stood up for the right things. And by the way, this is a King James Bible. You know, there's been a lot of country songs. And besides that, The King James Bible is the true word. People say there's mistakes. There ain't no mistakes. There's a mistake in your thought process if you think there's a mistake in the Bible. And unfortunately, like Mark Twain said, it's not the things in the Bible that I don't understand that scare me. It's the things in the Bible that I do understand that scare me. And that's quote unquote from Mark Twain, who supposedly died an agnostic or an atheist or something like that.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah. So, I mean, my hope and prayer is to see him in heaven. But obviously confessing Jesus Christ as your Savior is the gateway to heaven. Now, if you want to live your life some other way, I'm not legislating that on you at all. I believe in freedom of religion for every person. I'm just saying that this is where I found my peace. This is where the only person that died, was buried, and rose again the third day. That's the only God on the whole planet. There's never been one person in history that has those credentials to his name. And of course, he is the Son of God. He's the Creator. He was there in the beginning, like he said to the Father. And he was as a lamb, like it says in Revelation, he was the lamb slain from the foundation of the world. The lamb slain. Just like the Jewish people were instructed to slay a lamb for their atonement sins during Passover, the Christian also does the same thing when we take the Lord's Supper, the bread and the wine. We remember that his body was broken for us, which is the lamb. His blood was shed for us, which is the redemption and the washing away of the sin. And of course, the resurrection is something that was talked about in the Word as well. But Jesus fulfilled all of that when he was here in this world. And so thank God for a risen Savior. Thank God for a God that we can serve that's real, and that that everything in this Bible is going to move forward just like he said. And the kingdoms of this world are become the kingdoms of our Lord and of his Christ, and he shall reign forever and ever. And yeah, that includes the Jews, and you're not getting rid of the Jews. You know, the people on the Jews' side are going to be here forever. The people that are not won't be. So that's very clear in the Bible too, both Old Testament and New Testament. So I'm very much, if I wasn't a Christian, I would be a Jew. So God bless you. God bless America. God bless the Bible, the King James Bible especially. Although, you know, anybody can use any Bible they want to, and I'm not, again, legislating that, but this is the true word. God bless you. God bless America. You want to say something?
No, I think you've said it all.
How about God bless the Marine Corps?
God bless the Marine Corps.